For Doris Graham, there's a danger that when she pours hot tea into her mug, she could easily scald herself if she didn't have this small device sitting neatly on the side. This little gizmo tells her when the cup is full, because Doris is a registered blind person. That means she can see a little, but not enough to cope unaided.
And that's when they discovered that I'd got macular degeneration, which I had never, ever heard of. And from then on, life over the years, I've had it for 20 years now, it has gradually got a bit worse. Shopping is a pain. Buying clothes is a pain. Getting on buses, well, I always have a taxi into town and have a bus back, but I haven't been to Chichester, where I've been once this year.
Technology to help people with visual and hearing difficulties has developed dramatically in recent years. This machine, which helps Doris to read ordinary print, is just one such device. Only when you see them all together at an exhibition do you realise how much high-tech is now available to help with everyday, ordinary tasks.
Thousands of small children and families across West Sussex.
It may be technology, but it doesn't always have to be expensive.
Two chopping boards. The patterned one would be much more difficult to see things on. The red one, nice and clear, so you could get a good contrast. Okay. We have here a jug which has got some marks on the inside to help people find the levels by feeling inside. Here we've got t-shirts using safety pins in different places to identify different colours. And identifying tins, we've used some rubber bands here so that one soup has got two rubber bands on it and the different soup has got one rubber band.
We have a doorbell here, a cordless doorbell. Very simple, I'll just press it here. It makes a good loud sound and also a flashing light comes on after the sound. We have a pager system here which picks up alerting signals from a doorbell. A baby alarm can be connected to this for profoundly deaf mothers who can't hear the baby crying. Importantly, it picks up also the smoke alarm and the telephone ringing.
And talking of smoke alarms, here's one of several specifically designed to meet special needs.
It's basically for when they take out their hearing aids and when they go to bed at night. And during the day, if they're completely deaf, then we have the flashing light which tells them that the smoke alarm is going off. And we have a vibrating pad which goes under their pillow at night to wake them up.
There's only been time to show you just a few of the wide range of devices available.
Dark blue. Red.
If you'd like more information about what's on the market, you can contact our sensory services team on 01903 745 331.